Yes, sir, we are live. Now you can start. Hello? Hello?
Hello, Rishabh, ek minute, sir. Ahit, sir. हॅलो ऋषभ,
यस
सरांचा आवाज येत नाहीये. वी आर नॉट एबल टू हिअर सर. अनम्यूट केले का बघ बरं सर. ते कनेक्ट
सर एक्झिट झाले मीटिंग मधून. परत जॉईन करायला
Thank you. Are you able to hear me?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Sir. Yes, sir.
Excellent. Thank you so much. Now
Sir, we
we
can start.
I can start speaking, but now we need slides, no?
Yes, sir. I will share, sir.
Okay. Very good, very Am I audible to everybody? So
Yes,
that
sir.
I can start now. So start. Good
Yes, sir, we
afternoon.
can start, sir.
Yes, good afternoon, everybody. And I'm sorry that it got delayed for proper connectivity. Today is going to be my last lecture. We started on 22nd January, and we have practically completed about 40 hours of teaching. I divided the subject in four parts. The first was the classification of multiphase reactors and qualitative description of some. So I described about 35 to 40 reactors. The second one was for a given system, for a new system for which a multiphase reactor is to be designed, how to find the rate controlling step to determine the rate of reaction. That was the second part. The third was the actual process design. And in the process design, several design parameters are required. And how to establish design parameters is the fourth part. So, more or less, today's lecture will be devoted to the fourth part. But before I do that, I will give a summary of part two, part three we have done so that we will be able to appreciate part four. So let us go to the next slide. Next slide, please.
Yes, sir. Just a minute.
So, part two consisted of determination of rate controlling step that we executed through model filters. And we prepared a very systematic table, which is given in the next slide. That is, there is a very slow reaction regime, fast reaction regime, and instantaneous reaction regime. What we said was, before we start systematic experimentation, we take the system under consideration. Let it be solid liquid or solid gas or liquid liquid, and do contacting. Maybe in a small scale stirred vessel and 50% conversion. Just try to note very approximately how much time is required for 50% conversion. Now, if it is taking several hours, then typically it is slow. Now, this is not a hard and fast rule, but this is a rule of thumb. If it takes several minutes to few minutes, then it is in regime two. Then if it takes few minutes and seconds, then it is in the regime three. We call the reaction very fast. And if it takes seconds, then it is instantaneous. We derived in detail in column 2 the overall rate of reaction, and I emphasized at that time the overall rate is expressed as kilomoles per meter cube second. So in very slow reaction, the equation which we derived, that is written, and the conditions to be required are given in the third, that is mass transfer coefficient is much higher than the rate of chemical reaction, and therefore the condition controlled. And no reaction occurs in the film, and root M is an indicator of reaction happening in the film divided by reaction happening in the bulb. And we said root M when it is greater than 5, practically all the reaction occurs in the film. But when it is much less than 1, practically no occurs in the film. So that is our rating 1. Slow reaction, then mass transfer coefficient is much less than rate of chemical reaction, and root M is much less than 1. And in fast reaction regime, root M here I have written greater than 3, but safer value can be a 5. Whereas that enhancement input M has to be less than the enhancement factor V naught 1 Z star dB by dA. This ensures that V naught is always sufficient in the field. Whereas in the instantaneous reaction regime, there is a reaction plane in the film, and overall reaction is controlled by diffusion of both A and B. Now, this background I had described, I'm showing it. Now, how to use this slide using the model contactor. So, next slide. So, we saw from the rate of reaction that epsilon L appears only in very slow reaction, the regime 1. So, overall rate will depend epsilon L only in the reaction, not in second, third, and fourth. And fourth, it is proportional to KL. Then as regards to interfacial area, in second, third, and fourth, proportional to A. As regards to A star, it is proportional to A star in second regime. It is mth order in the first regime, m plus 1 by 2 in the third regime, and it doesn't depend upon A star in the fourth regime. As far as this is concerned, it is proportional to B naught raised to N. I constructed this table in the classroom, whereas in second regime, it is independent of B naught. Third regime, it is raised to N by 2, and again, it is proportional to B naught in the fourth regime. The rate constant also we saw. The rate constant doesn't appear in second and fourth regime, whereas it is proportional to rate constant in the regime and square root of rate constant in the third regime. On the basis of these observations, how to make these observations, I solved 2 examples in the class. In the tutorial class, Abhijit also solved additional 5 problems. That is, after making these observations, how to make sense of these observations. Maybe some of them, maybe one example, I present all over again in order to connectivity between these 4 parts. Next slide. So these observations we made with the help of a model contactor, and here is a stirred cell, which is a sort of workhorse. It is used in majority of cases. We have gas liquid interface, which is visible. There is one impeller in the liquid phase and very high speed impeller in the gas phase. There is gas outlet, there is a gas inlet, and the gas flow rate is kept so high that practically engine partial pressure occurs. So the estimation of partial pressure becomes very simple, is equal to inlet partial pressure. So the effect of A star, which is proportional to partial pressure, effect of B naught, that is we can change concentration basis in the liquid phase. The KLA we can change with the help of impeller speed. Interfacial area we can change since the square per meter cube of the contactor, by changing the level of the interface, meter square per meter cube. So whatever it's shown in the earlier table, Abhijit, previous table, please. So dependence upon epsilon L, that we try to do of the location of interface in the contactor. If the contactor is 20 centimeters in height, you can keep 5 centimeters, 10, 15, 12, 11 centimeters. That's how the dependence of it. Then A star we change by changing the partial pressure. B naught, I told you, the reactive absorbent, and that concentration B naught change. Proportional to interfacial area also we check with the help of keeping a proper liquid level. We can keep, as I told you, 5 centimeters, 10 centimeters, 12 centimeters. That will change interfacial area, meter square per meter cube. And KL we vary with the help of impeller speed. So we first of all see the effect of impeller speed, that is KL. If it is dependent on KL, then it is either in second regime or fourth regime. So when that is the case, then we quickly see the effect of A star. So effect of A star is proportionality in second regime, whereas it is independent of A star. And as far as B naught is concerned, it is independent of B naught in second and proportional to B naught in fourth. So this clarifies whether we are in second, and both second and fourth it is equal to impeller speed, but in second it is proportional to A star, independent of A star in fourth, independent of B naught in. So we can identify which regime we are operating. And after, then the next important point is we need to make it reaction controlled. So the rate constant appears either in third regime or fourth regime. First regime and third regime. So if we are in between first and are in second and we want to make it first, then first thing first is we can reduce constant by reducing the operating temperature. We know that the rate constant reduces by a factor of 2 when the temperature is reduced by 10 degrees. So if you reduce by 10 degrees, say 20 degrees and 30 degrees, we can keep on reducing and make K larger than epsilon L Kmn S star raised to M minus B naught raised to N. So after getting into the first regime, then what do we do? Now we know mass transfer resistance is not participating the role. We change the partial pressure, hence change the A star over a wide range. Plot log of rate versus log of A star and get order with respect to A star. Similarly, change in wide range, again make a similar plot and get the N. M and N are known and epsilon L is known. Kmn can be calculated from the rate equation. And if experiments are done at variety of temperatures, we can get the activation energy. From third regime, if you go to second regime, if you wish to go to third regime, or from fourth regime to third regime, let us discuss first of all to third. We increase the rate constant first of all. So when we increase the constant, that can again be done with the help of temperature. So if you want to change the rate constant 8 times, then increase the temperature by 30 degrees. That is one way of doing it. The second one is we want root m of the order of 5. So by increasing Kmn, we are increasing the numerator. So the way is to reduce the denominator, that is the value of true mass transfer coefficient. That can be done with equipment which naturally gives low KL. So stir cell gives low KL, pack column gives low KL, weighted wall column gives low KL, weighted cylinder gives low KL. Whereas laminar jet apparatus, the bubble columns or stirred vessels, these give very high KL, maybe 3 to 4 times higher than the other type of equipment. So we'll increase the root M. We can also increase A star by increasing partial pressure. We can take more concentration of B naught. Basically, bring root M greater than 5 so that all the reaction happens in the liquid phase. However, we need to make B naught by Z star much larger than root M. And again, we play with B naught and A star. Here we'll have to reduce. So we'll have B naught and A star that the value becomes greater than 5 for root M. B naught by Z star, that value becomes greater than root M. Once we are in third regime, then again we plot rate versus A star to get M plus 1 by 2, from which we can get M. And we'll get N by 2 when we plot log rate versus log B naught. We get M and N, and hence we get rate constant. Diffusivity, the various methods of calculating, and I suggest book by Properties of Gases and Liquids by Reed, Sherwood, and Prosnitz. And his handbook also, the methods are given for estimating diffusivity. So this is how the part two is executed. Next slide. So then I covered a variety of model contacts. What I said was the two characteristic features of model contactors are, one is interfacial area is known, and second is, can I have a pointer here? Yeah, very good. So here interfacial area is known for this sitting cylinder contactor. The portion of the cylinder which is exposed is interfacial area, and KL can be changed by rotational speed. So these are the two characteristic features. Stirred cell cross-sectional area was interfacial area, and impeller speed was changing the mass transfer coefficient. So here also, for bringing into first and third regime, we change the rotational speed, the partial pressure, the creation of A star, and the temperature. Next slide. This is yet another model contactor, that is weighted wall column. The liquid is through hollow pipe, it overflows, and there is a liquid film falling outside the pipe. So interfacial area is pi DL. This is what is exposed. This is exposed. And the interfacial area is known, and we can change the value of KL by changing the flow rate. Of course, S star can be changed by partial pressure, can be changed the liquid phase concentration, and rate constant can be changed by temperature. So always we can measure MN and KMN, and then over a wide range of, in the actual contactor, there is a certain inlet pressure and we want to consume most of it, say 98%. So over such a wide range, with the help of model contactor, we try to establish What is the rate of reaction? Once we know the kinetics, we can find out whether it is in the first regime, second regime, third regime, or fourth regime for different values of V naught, S star, KL, and KMN. And locally, we find the overall rate of reaction. Maybe it is cleanly in the regimes, or it can be combination of first and second, second and third, etc. And I taught you how to calculate the rate if it is between first and second, etc. So the next model contactor is wetted sphere. So sphere area, exposed area to the gas is interfacial area. Changing the flow rate of liquid which falls from the top, we change the migration. The liquid flows over the first sphere, second sphere, third sphere, and then it collected in the collector at the bottom. And there is a facility to take samples from the inlet and outlet to understand the overall rate of reaction. Next slide. This is the jet apparatus. There is a jet at the top and a receiver at the bottom. The liquid jet starts from the top jet. Let us start at the top jet, that is the jet, and it falls in the receiver. And the jet is exposed for that small portion, and that pi dl is the area, and mass transfer coefficient is changed by varying the jet speed. Next slide. This was in detail in the class, but as a summary lecture, I'm just revising. This third contactor, when it is in the first regime and slow reaction, for getting kinetics, equipment becomes useful because anyway, we want more and more value of KLA. And here in the form of bubbles, a lot of interfacial area is there. And we can easily make KLA much greater than epsilon L S star minus 1 V naught S square KML. So for first regime, we use this third contactor. Next slide. Then we solid gas and solid liquid reactions. The property with solids is, once the size distribution is measured, we know the interfacial area. So one of the requirements of a model contactor is satisfied with the help of the particle size distribution. However, the true mass transfer coefficient we need to change, and in the Carberry reactor, which left bottom, by changing speed of the basket, rotational speed, we can change KL. Whereas in the Berti reactor, the volumetric flow rate is changed. There is an annular catalyst bed. There is an axial flow impeller or centrifugal impeller by which the liquid over the catalyst, and it falls down in the central region. When it falls down to the central region of the impeller, it is taken to the tip of the impeller and then it goes to the catalyst bed. So this is how the liquid flow rate is changed or gas flow rate is changed and true mass transfer coefficient is changed. Next slide. So yet another contactor. The good part, as I'm just repeating, the size distribution or particle size distribution helps us. So at the top, it is simple CSTR, the linear one, whereas it can be a batch reactor. But the principle is the same. Interfacial area is known, and mass transfer coefficient is changed by changing the impeller speed. The bottom left is the pipeline reactor, where the flow rate is changed by, we have inlet flow rate. The reaction occurs in the catalyst bed, and there is a product. Part of the product stream is recycled and comes back, so that we get a provision for changing the liquid flow rate. That is the net product coming out of the reactor. We can take only 10% and change, recycle 90%, recycle 99%, 70%. So that can change the flow rate and change the true mass transportation. Then we solve the problems, and first problem I had solved. Some experiments were performed in wetted wall column 2 cm diameter to discuss mechanism of absorption of A in an aqueous solution containing species B. Following data were obtained. Now, following data were obtained means with the help of model conductor, that is wetted wall column, was operated, and partial pressure was varied over a wide range. V naught was varied over a wide range, and the observations are the rate of absorption of A was independent of liquid flow rate in the flow rate of 1 to 4 cm. So what it means, it was KL independent. Rate of absorption of A was independent of the concentration of B. Now that table which I showed you at the beginning, that we should bring in front of us. When it is independent of B, then we are in second regime. When it is proportional to B, in the fourth regime. What is the mechanism of absorption A? Then we can quickly say that it is in the second regime. It may be noted that independent series of experiments indicated that reactions first order in A. Right. Suppose the above system is separately studied in laminar jet apparatus, that is the true value of KL is increased 3-4 times, point out the set of conditions under which the specific rate of absorption of A could become a function of a liquid flow rate. Now, when it has to become function of liquid flow rate, it should be dependent. And KL dependent means either in second reading or fourth reading. But here we want the point out the set of conditions under which the specific absorption of A could become a function of liquid flow rate. So we have to bring either in the second regime or fourth regime, either increase the temperature further to make it instantaneous or make it slow, make root M in such a way, adjust the value so that it is less than one. So this is how we solve the problems. When we read it, we are just revising it today. These examples were solved in detail in class, and I had requested each one of you to solve these 40 problems. You will become real expert in the design of multiphase reactors, particularly analysis of the rate controlling step whenever there are multiple steps. We'll read maybe number 12 or whatever you wish, Abhijit. Let us take that example. Right. The following available for an irreversible reaction, which is zero order with respect to solute gas. Now, in a model contactor, you must have realized that the instigator got zero order. Let it be stirred cell or laminar jet or wetted one or wetted sphere column or wetted cylinder column. The investigator had changed partial pressure over a wide range, maybe from 2% to 100%, and found that there is no effect of partial pressure. Rate doesn't depend upon partial pressure or A star, and therefore order with respect to A is zero. And for with respect to B, that order is found by changing the liquid phase concentration. Stoichiometric factor, that is A plus ZB is equal to products, is given one. Diffusivity of A is given, diffusivity is given. Solubility of A in aqueous phase, that is Henry's coefficient is given 8 × 10⁻⁷. And first order rate constant is given. In the range of concentration of B relevant to this work, there was practically no physical properties in the space. That is basically the diffusivity. And there was no reduction in the solubility of A. Basic rate of absorption of pure A at atmospheric pressure in a stirred cell at a speed of stirring, where KL in the absence of chemical reaction was 0.003 centimeter per second and the concentration of B was zero. So some observations are the specific rate of absorption in a continuous bubble column when the partial pressure of A was 5 atmosphere and the concentration of B in the outgoing liquid was 008 gram per liter. It may be assumed that the liquid phase in the bubble column is almost completely backmixed and there is no significant change in the part. So what I'm stressing is we make such observations in the model contactor and then try to analyze it the methodology explained in the class as well as I explained it ago. If you have any difficulties, you can always email me and we can have either a separate session or I can reply to the individual emails. Next slide. Maybe we can go further. These are the problems which have been selected. Is this problem? Yeah. So this table is again made. This is one of the examples to calculate the interfacial area. Pure H2S at atmospheric pressure was absorbed in laminar jet. Abhijit, get pack column where we calculated interfacial area. Interfacial area was 1.3 or something. Back column having diameter of 5 centimeters, height of, same. So here data is given, the following data were obtained for absorption of CO2 from air by means of absorption with chemical reaction using aqueous sodium hydroxide solution. So it is CO2 plus NaOH giving Na2CO3 plus water. And column was 10 centimeter and packed height was centimeter with 1 centimeter ceramic rashid rings as the packings. Calculate the specific interfacial area. Now the reaction is proportional to interfacial area only in the third region. In the second and fourth, it is proportional to KLA. So that A is together with KL. So we will not get independent answer with A to be in third regime. And for third regime, root M has to be greater than 5, less than V naught by Z star. And from that we get overall volumetric rate of reaction, which is equal to A. We calculate other values. So let us see the solution procedure. Next slide. So from the observations, we have made a listing, a list of parameters. The actual system is carbon dioxide diluted by air to be absorbed in aqueous solution of sodium. Equipment is packed column. Diameter is 10 centimeters. Length is 55 centimeters. Packing is 1 centimeter. A star at certain partial pressure, that is, perhaps the pure H2S is given, value of DA, diffusivity of A is given, the rate constant is given, the superficial liquid is given, inlet concentration, outlet concentration of caustic soda is given. Next slide. So here, first of all, from super gas velocity, volumetric flow rate has been calculated. and it is 16.72 into 10 raised to minus 3, then we know NaOH, what is reacted from inlet and outlet concentration, and therefore we know stoichiometric 1 mole of CO2 moles of caustic soda, and therefore CO2 reacted, end of the slide, bottommost CO2 reacted is 3.51 into 10 raised to minus 3 gram mole per second. We have repeatedly said that we express this in the form of gram mole per cc second. Next slide. So therefore, we need to calculate the total packed volume, volume of the equipment, which was 4.32, and we know gram mole per second, and from that we now calculate gram cc second, which is given by bold letters 8.13 into 10 raised to minus 7. This is all red. And if you want interfacial area, we need to bring it in the third regime. So let us see what is the value of root M. Next slide. So the value of root M in third regime, the rate in gram mole per cc second is proportional to interfacial area, and A star N2 upon M plus 1, the rate equation is given. So we know left hand side, we need to know A star M N for getting interfacial area. So RA we calculated in the previous slide, and therefore RA divided by A star into root DAK1 has been added, and effective interfacial area in the packed column given. Now, our problems have been given to expose you to different situations of observations in the model contactor. I appeal all of you to solve these problems yourself, and whenever you have any difficulty, you can write to me by email. Next slide. So this was part two. What is important in the equipment, let it be bubble column, sectionalized bubble column, external loop airlift reactor, or classical pack column, or reactor, or sparge loop reactor, or rotating disk contactor, or pulse extraction column. These model contactors I explained for gas liquid, but all of them can be used for liquid-liquid also, where surface can be kept visibly flat in stirred cell and the simulations can be drawn. So the most important point that we should remember that inlet to outlet in a given equipment, bubble column or stirred tank or rotating disk contactor or a packed column or wetted wall column, from inlet to outlet, radially and axially, the partial pressure changes. V naught changes. Interfacial area may change, may not change. Transfer coefficient may change, may not change. Catalyst concentration, it changes. There may be temperature variation in the column. So what is important is at any point in the reactor, the regime of operation and overall rate of it differs from point to point. And this is what is important, what I in the solved example. So when the equipment is backmix, this means V naught and A star are uniform throughout the equipment. Concentration is same throughout, regime is same throughout, which is equal to outlet concentration. And we can easily find the overall rate of reaction. But when one phase is plug flow and another is backmix, then the rate keeps on changing. When both are plug flow, the rate is changing. But in reality, none of the phases are either plug flow or backmix. They are in between. Therefore, I derived in class the dispersed plug flow model, the 9-RDL flow, and with the help of that, whatever variation in equation of S star and V naught, how to integrate that from inlet to outlet, that I explained. So here, the oxidation of sodium sulfide, 2 moles of oxygen react with 2 moles of sodium sulfide. The equation which is seen here on this slide, which gives sodium sulfide plus caustic soda plus sulfur. So first of all, we solve this example for mechanically agitated reactor where both gas phase and liquid are back mixed. And therefore, within the reactor, the partial pressure is same as the outlet partial pressure. Now, when we solve the problem, initially, know the inlet concentration of, say, B naught, and what is the possible level of conversion, or that is also not known. So what is not known? We know the inlet concentration or initial concentration. We know the how much is wanted in terms of gram mole per second. The possible range of temperature is known. Perhaps catalyst is known. And then how to begin? Because more or less we know nothing. And under these conditions, how to start? Therefore, we start in an arbitrary manner. One thing we have made is that we are going to design a mechanical agitated reactor. This decision has changed, but let us take that as a starting point and design the mechanical agitated contactor, try to get an answer volume of mechanical agitated contactor. What is the diameter? What is the height? What is the horsepower required? What is the shaft? What is the impeller that can be used? So this was explained to you in detail in the class. And after getting that, then it is a good idea that in some other contactor, we can design different types of equipment. When we are fresh engineers, it is always a good idea not to assume anything that this contactor is better than that contactor. Keep on designing all, create first-hand experience. So we design all the equipment. Are you able to hear me?
Yes, sir.
Abhijit, we are able to. Abhijit?
Yes, sir, we can hear you, sir.
Very, very good, very good. So, now we need to pass air. So whether we should use 200% excess, 100% excess, 50%, 10% excess, 5% excess, 1% excess. So we consider our possibilities. We consider all the levels of conversion, 90%, 98%, 95%, 90%. And when it is unreacted, it will give less capacity. Our original problem of the sodium sulfide, we wanted to eliminate mainly because in the boiler, it was creating H2S. And therefore, we want as complete conversion as possible. So for this particular problem, we cannot take very generations of outlet, definitely want more than 99% conversion. So at different temperatures, different conversions, different percentage excess of A, different total, different partial pressure, we calculate the equipment sizes and equipment sizes of also a variety of equipment. And when we solve such examples, maybe 5 times, 10 times, then we get experience, and then the calculation procedure becomes shorter, mainly because of prior experience. Next slide. Let us see, this is in between, I think, first and second regime, and we got the rate, 1.07 into 10 raised to minus 6, kilomole per meter cube second, and overall rate is also known, root much less than 5, much less than 1. So it is either of second regime, that is no reaction occurs in the film, but it is in between first and second. In fact, it may be at the where B naught is very less, it may be reaction controlled, whereas at the top it may be mass transfer controlled. But once we write between 1 and 2, the respective values of B naught and KLA will take care of any location depending upon local value, it will take the rate. The overall rate here for B naught exit, because now here exit B naught is the same everywhere and KLA is same. So back mix case is the simplest case, but simplified case. So we got this rate and we got the volume of, next slide, 319 meter cube. Try to understand. So typically, if you want good gas liquid dispersion, then we put energy through impeller of the order of 2 kilowatt per meter cube. So this needs about 638 kilowatt hour kilowatt motor, or we will have to install 750 kilowatt and extract 638 kilowatt from this. This equipment is easy to design, but very expensive, because we have designed the bubble column where the power is also low and equipment cost is also low. So let us see bubble column. This is how the part two I taught, either the one of the phases, both the phases can be back mix. One can be other back mix, or first, second flow, or both flow, or both away from ideal behavior, but non-ideal behavior. So we locally calculate the overall rate and keep on integrating the performance from bottom to top till we get the conversion and hence find the dimensions. So this was part two. Here bubble column has been designed. The solution procedure was sent to you, and action has been done from bottom to top. And finally, the answer is some diameter is 2.31 and power consumption is only 20 kilowatt in place of 638 kilowatt. Sectionalized bubble column makes it plug flow, and therefore the power also goes down, but most importantly, volume goes from 127 to 81. External loop reactor volume goes down to 84. So it is a good idea that you solve this. I'm sure you must have solved, but when we take pipeline with pure oxygen, then it is only 5 meter cube. And I had shown that by little bit increasing total pressure at the top of the bubble column, we can reduce the power consumption as well as volume of the reactor. So this completed the part three, but let us go back into the, let it be any rate equation. So let us show the regime two or regime two. Just go back by one slide. One more. Let us see the third regime or between first and second. Yeah. Stop. Wait. Yeah, wait here. Okay. So here, first and second, we need to know the gas holdup or liquid holdup. We need to know rate constant, right? We need to know the that is variation of temperature. We need to know In some of the cases, we need to know heat transfer coefficient also. So, hold up, interfacial area, mass transfer coefficient. What is the source of these design parameters? And this is the most complex subject in chemical engineering. Actually, I take separate course on this, the theories of heat and mass transfer. Right now, there is no fundamental theory which is proposed in chemical engineering from which we can calculate any parameters like interfacial area. And therefore, what people do, they perform experiments in the laboratory. Suppose we want interfacial area in our gas hold up in the bubble column. So what they do is take a bubble column, and in the laboratory recommendation is take the column diameter at least 15 centimeters and a height to diameter ratio more than, and when it is filled by liquid, it's a height to diameter ratio 5, and when we pass gas from the bottom, there is an expansion, that is the level in rise in liquid level. So the increased level, that is height of dispersion minus clear height in absence of gas divided by total height gives the gas holder. So in this manner, the interfacial area related. So interfacial area depends upon diameter, column height, the sparger design means the whole diameter, the number of, then it also depends upon the range of superficial gas velocity, the superficial liquid velocity. It also depends upon liquid properties like liquid density, liquid viscosity, surface tension, gas density, gas viscosity. So there are 16 parameters on which holdup depends, and such kinds of holdup are done over a wide range of these parameters, and then empirical or semi-empirical equation on the basis of totally empirical or semi-empirical, then we form the dimensionless numbers like Reynolds number and Sherwood number, Prandtl number, Nusselt number, and try to correlate. So some of these correlations. Now we are coming to 4, that is final part. And the most important point to be remembered is estimation of design parameters. The current state of the art in chemical engineering is to use some correlations which are available in the published literature. Now such correlations are, there are books on back columns, there are 7 or 8 different books on stirred tanks, and on each equipment, Perry's handbook covers, there is Albright's handbook, which has a variety of equipment. And then there are published reviews in journals on specific equipment, which correlations are given. So for 2 typical equipment, bubble columns and stirred tanks, I have compiled the correlations for you. And all these slides which I'm showing today are being sent to you. So let us see the questions. Right. So these are the summary of correlations for a process side heat transfer coefficient. That is, whenever there is a bubble column and heat is to be transferred, then inside the bubble column, that is called process side, and outside where a jacket provided, then that is jacket transfer. So right from Chilton, left hand side is Nusselt number, is a function of Reynolds number and Prandtl number and mu by mu w. I think this is the for pitch black turbine. Again, it is a different correlation, and these correlations are developed, as I mentioned to you, by performing experiments. If you worked up D by T, T is varied, and that way Reynolds varied Prandtl number V vary by changing either Cp, mu or K. Next slide. So which is for different impellers, impeller designs and D by T, different correlations are given. Here power number, different correlations are given. So that we can calculate the power consumption. Summary of correlations for gas hold up in gas liquid stirred tank. So here are various variety of correlations. Typically 10 to 15 correlations are available. Now here is the power consumption. Earlier were correlations for in the absence of gas. This is in presence of gas. So in absence of gas, we calculate using correlations, and in presence of gas divided by in absence of gas, Pg by P0, the three correlations. Next slide. Again, for variety of impellers, the value of Pg by P0 is given. Next slide. What I'm trying to say, that variety of correlations are available for whatever you want. Now here, critical impeller speed for suspension of solid particles. That critical speed depends on the solid quantity, that is X, then the settling value, which is proportional to G delta rho upon rho L raised to 0.5. It also depends upon viscosity, gamma raised to 0.2, and depends upon particle size, as well as the impeller diameter. So the correlation for suspension of solid particles. Next slide. So what I have to do is for any parameter, correlations are there. Now start next one is perhaps a bubble pump. Various gas liquid systems. So we can start with anything that you wish to show. This we have done. Yes. Bubble column, summary of correlations for volumetric mass transfer coefficients for different gas liquid systems. There is a certain problem of them. Let us go to the parity plot. That is, suppose for a gas hold up, there are 15 correlations. There are 15 correlations which are listed here. Yoshida and Hikita and Kikukawa, all these equations. Now the experimental values are 6,000 data points have been collected by workers at various vessel diameter, vessel height, sparger diameter, liquid phase properties, gas velocity, liquid velocity, 6,000 experiments are there. And these experimental values have been compared with the correlation. And you can see the correlations don't do a good job normally. And this is the main thing of chemical engineering, that we are still in the age of empiricism, and empiricism has many limitations. And the three limitations, let me tell you, that first limitation is the range of parameters covered in the laboratory, they are not quite extensive as compared to the commercial science. What's important is the diameter. The flow patterns in the bigger equipment, suppose there is a circulation eddy, then it is of the size of column diameter. And therefore, the intensity of mixing or the residence time of gas phase is different. So the first limitation of empiricism is the range of parameters covered is different than the range of parameters in the. The most important limit is here in empirical correlation, the hold up, say for example, if you want, that is considered as a directly related to the parameters. That is, there is a direct relationship. Whereas in reality, what happens for a typical gas velocity, effect of viscosity is can be put up is inversely proportional viscosity raised to 0.3. But if gas velocity is say 20 centimeters per second, then effect of viscosity may be negligible. So getting hold up as a direct function of that is not a good idea. And therefore, recently in our group, what we have done, whenever any parameter is a function of variety of parameters, and I told you in stirred tank, how many parameters are there? The vessel diameter, vessel height, the impeller design of impellers, the location of impellers, the impeller diameter, then gas flow rate, the liquid flow rate, liquid phase properties like density and viscosity, and surface tension, gas phase density and viscosity. So these many parameters are there. So lot of data are there. And these are dependent on other, that is effect of gas velocity may depend upon liquid viscosity. Effect of liquid viscosity may depend upon impeller diameter or Reynolds number. In our group, we have made an attempt to use artificial intelligence, and you can see the red points, which are closer to the parity line, and the error is not more than 20%. So this is a new development, and now correlations are being based on AI type of equipment. If we were in the class, I would tell you artificial intelligence. But in this mode of teaching, that is not permissible. You can remember that the better option than empirical correlations is AI-based correlations, artificial intelligence-based correlations. I will tell you now, this artificial intelligence, this particular development is of last 3 years, and I'm sure it is progressing further. But I'm going to give you my practical experience of now I'm designing all the chemical engineering equipment for about 50 years. So how to do that? So what we do is the problem is always with the proportionality constant. Take any one correlation. Anyone, anything is okay. Say, first one, Nikita and Kikukama, that is 0.505 Vg raised to 0.47, 72 upon sigma L. Now, here, what we should do. Now, next 5 minutes are very, very important, and I invite attention of everybody. Whatever I'm saying, it is practical and very useful. That is, in the laboratory, we should have a small bubble column of 15 inch diameter and about 1 meter height. We should also have a stirred tank of 50 liter volume. Whatever equipment we want to design, the small scale equipment should be there. And the real system for which to design, we can have several liters of the liquid as well as the gas in the form of either cylinders or with the help of a generator. And we do perform only few experiments, maybe 4 or 5 experiments. And from those 5 experiments, typically the 72 upon sigma L raised to 7 by 3 and 1 upon mu L raised to 0.03 and Vg raised to 7, these normally hold. What doesn't hold is 0.505. So we do experiments in the laboratory and then take one of these correlations and try to adjust only the proportionality constant. Take Rayleigh's correlation, Vg raised to 0.44, sigma L raised to minus 0.16, rho L raised to minus 0.98, and rho g raised to 0.19, plus 0.009. So we should worry more about 296, and that we try to adjust with the few experiments in the laboratory. So this thumb rule you keep in mind, it is very difficult. The process design, up to process design we can come, but in the process design we need interfacial area, we need hold up, we need heat transfer coefficient, and right now we need to estimate from empirical correlations and improve the validity of empirical correlations by a few experiments in the laboratory, so that in that parity plot where the error was 1000%, by performing these experiments, we can bring down the error considerably so that our design will be closer to the reality or closer to the optimum design. One point which I have said few times, which I want to say it again, is the final decision is governed by the capital cost and operating cost. So initially we need not worry which equipment we are designing. Let us design a variety of equipment and with different levels of conversion, different excess of percentage gas, different levels of temperature, different levels of pressure, different column diameters, different column heights, and try to estimate how much money we need to spend for purchasing that. And for operating that column or operating the stir tank, what is the size of the motor and how many kilowatt hour sending every hour? And therefore we operate the plant about 8,000 hours per year. So how much money we are spending per year. And this capital cost, we need to capitalize by depreciation. And every year it can be depreciation as 10. There are different laws of depreciation. The simplest is 10% of the capital cost is annualized plus operating cost. And we calculate for all the combinations separately. And the combination which gives the least of the summation of depreciation and interest is the final answer. This final statement, you remember, there is like an answer. The answer may change from location to location, because from location to location, the prices of metals keep on changing, compressors keep on changing. Most importantly, the power cost. The power cost is 10 rupees a unit in India. It is about 5 rupees a unit in United States. It is 3 rupees in 5 rupees in Europe, 3 rupees in United States, and 1 or 2 rupees in Sweden, and practically no power cost in Middle East. So the optimum design will keep on changing, because from nation to nation, location to location, in our country also, the industrial areas have been divided into A, B, C, D, and the power costs, the water costs, and other utility costs, they depend upon A, B, C, D zone. So you will have to look at this. So the point is, for a given question, for a given liquid-liquid, gas-liquid, solid-liquid, gas-liquid-solid system, we perform experiments in the laboratory using model contactors, try to establish the rate controlling step and overall rate of reaction for a given combination of partial pressures and total pressures and liquid phase concentrations. And we integrate performance in order to get the performance. And For getting those senses, we need the values of desired parameters, which we get from empirical correlations, and validity of empirical relations we improve by performing several experiments in the laboratory and try to bring down. But final decision depends upon the annualized cost. That is, we should collect a lot of experience how to assess the cost of a system, external nuclear lift reactor or packed column. For last 50 years, I remember the cost of packings. How many packings are there? Rashik rings, balls, interlock saddles, then metal interlock saddles. Then there are structure packings of a variety of types. And I know the cost, I remember by heart, these costs per meter cube of these packings. See the different impellers, shafts, and materials of construction. Aluminium is costing 40 rupees, SS316, 300 rupees a kilogram, titanium, 2000 rupees a kilogram, Estella, 3000 rupees, and the cast iron, 50 rupees a kilogram. So these numbers we need not remember. These are available in the market cost. But the point is, there are variety of combinations which are possible, and we should be able to recommend an optimum design on the basis of the chemical engineering knowledge. Artificial intelligence is coming up, and with the help of costing and optimization, the optimum design of a multi-phase reactor. I stop here. Thank you for listening to my lectures. But whatever you have not understood, you can write an email. I'm sure you know my email. You can write, Abhijit, have an email to everybody?
No, sir, not yet, sir.
So we can communicate to everybody, jbzoshi at gmail.com.
Yes,
and reply all the emails. So I thank our HBNI staff, Anurag and his colleague, and Abhijit took a lot of pains in making slides, and he understood the subject, and he took several tips. And I thank all of you for attending my course. So today we conclude. We have completed approximately 40 hours of teaching. There you will get an email from HBNI. Those who wish to have credits, they should report their names to HBNI, and we will hold an examination where those 40 problems will be definitely important, and modern contractors, the method of process design, the optimization, empirical correlations, the points you try to understand and recollect, and the examination will be, normally I give very simple examination, and you will be able to get credits out of this course. So under close.
Sir, I will contact him, sir.
You will contact him. Okay. So can I go out?
Yes, sir, you can, sir.
Thank you.